Welcome to Healthy G Moms. Ooh, ooh. Welcome to Healthy G Moms. Welcome around the world. Welcome to my world. Welcome to Healthy G Moms. Welcome, you guys. Welcome back to my world. I want to thank you to all my subscribers, my new subscribers, my old subscribers. Yes, indeed, I am so grateful and thankful for you guys helping a sister out. Yes, indeed. The month of October first started out really, really great because it was my birthday month, the last day of September. So I celebrate my birthday in October. But I kind of got sick because of my gremlin. I explained that to you. My gremlin and his friend, and I got a fever blister. And I just was fatigued. And towards the end of the month, I just started feeling like, what the feezy? What is going on with me? Why am I feeling this way? And so the whole month went by and really didn't do too many videos because I was just like bah humbug or whatever it is you called it. I don't want to say depressed, but I just wasn't feeling that Glenda, that spark. But I had so many people that reached out to me. Yes, indeed. I had so many wonderful subscribers like Betty G. Gathers, my sister Benita, Vicky Tolliver. It's just so many people. My brother Richard that motivated me and said, what is up? You got this. You can do this. And I had a good family member, Darkest, put on the internet today, because today I wasn't really going to do nothing again. But she put on the interview. She said, guess what? Today is November. And yeah, I'm paraphrasing. But basically, in a nutshell, she said, today is November the 1st. And we are hoping and praying that it's going to be better than last month. And it's going to be better. So I chose to say, you know what up, G? I put on my old school gear. That's why you see my tennis shoes, my K-Swiss in the house. I got my oxygen out. I've been practicing without my oxygen. Yes, indeed. I'm always practicing. Yes, indeed. I got on my favorite color. If y'all don't know by now, my favorite color is green. I got my letter G on my neck, representing G, Glenda, Goldie. Yeah, high school, I was a varsity cheerleader. Yes, indeed. I was a varsity cheerleader and I was student body vice president. You know, I had to remind myself, like, girl, you better get it together. Because once upon a time, you used to be somebody. And then you worked at a TV station and all that. But I had to dig down to my roots. My old school days when I was, you know, tennis shoe pimping. And like trying to get myself together. Trying to figure out, you know, the world. I had so many opportunities. So I tell you guys, learn from me. Because sometimes when you just think that you want to give up, reach back. Reach back. Reach back and figure out, what was it? What was it? Yes, indeed. What was it that made you spectacular? What was it? It was so many things that pushed me. So many people that pushed me. I started looking at my body. I was like, you know what? My stomach is not flat, but, you know, it's a work in progress. I still wear shorts. You know, I can put on shorts, you know? I can still move. I can't do splits like I want to. I tried to do a cartwheel. I'm gonna work on that. I tried to do a cartwheel. I was digging real deep. Like what? What is up with you? What can you do? So I started saying, you know what? I'm gonna be thankful because you could be back in that hospital. I'm gonna be thankful and grateful for having a roof over my head. Because so many things has been going wrong in this building. But you know what? What about the good stuff, Glenda? What about what you've been trying to do with your life? Yes, trying to buy a home, become a homeowner again. You got accepted into the program, the FSS program. And you woke up. Yes, indeed, you've been waking up every day. So yes, Healthy G and Mom, Healthy G in the house. Working it out. Yes, indeed. I can't really do it. You know, I'm a one-hand photographer. I wonder if you guys have another perspective of what my life has been like. Doing everything by myself. Everything by myself. Yes, but it's okay. Because I'm constantly pushing on. And I'm here to show you guys that you too can constantly push on. Tennis shoe pimping. And I say pimping, it's just because I'm a K-Swiss person. Yes, you get a better look at it. You can see there's these old, old tennis shoes. K-Swiss with my green shoe strings. I've always wore K-Swiss since I can ever afford, since I've been able to afford K-Swiss, right in the 8th, 9th grade. Yes, and yes, I've been thankful that, you know, I can still fit into some shorts, you know, and my son is healthy, and, you know, I'm a work in progress, but I want you guys to dig deep in your heart and figure out what it is. You know, be grateful. I'm grateful for my paintings, home. This is home. So I convince myself, you know what? It's not your house, but it's somebody else's house that you're paying for, and you got a roof over your head. And, you know, you got a beautiful view, you know, of LA and the Palm Springs, you know? So yes, indeed. You know, you got beautiful plants. Yes. You know, I'm trying to get that green thumb. I got prints. I've been growing some vegetables inside, and we'll talk about that another day. Got Aragarden, so that's romaine, some romaine lettuce. And these are chives and basil, things that I just planted. You know, so, you know, be thankful. I'm thankful, and I'm grateful of having the opportunity to have part two of my life. Yes, part two of my life of trying to be bigger and better, of being the person that I know that God want me to be. Bear with me, guys, because my subscribers and my family and people have reached out to me to say, you know what? You can do this. And I start reaching back and start saying, you were a varsity cheerleader. You were student body vice president. You were a member of the Black Caucus. You got accepted into the Ebony Showcase from the 9th and 11th grade. You got 12th grade, you got paid to go to school. And then in the summer, you got a chance to have the opportunity to be at USC. Sister from the hood. Yes, indeed. I come from entrepreneurs. They taught me how to grow things. That's why I'm trying to grow a garden. So I'm really, really digging deep. Dig deep. So I tell you guys, dig deep. What can you do? What can you do? What can you do to push through? I'm showing you guys on November 1st, 2021, I decided to push through again. Because when I first got out of the hospital, I was pushing through. But then I thought about, you know what, Glenn? You were in the hospital. You couldn't walk. You couldn't talk. You had 24-hour nurses around you. Then you got out. And, yeah, you don't live in the best part place. But you are so positive. Get that positive mindset back to know that you're going to be a homeowner again. To know that you will be driving a Benz. Maybe a Bentley coupe that you want. I'm putting it into the universe because I manifest myself back to life. Yes, I did. So I'm going to manifest, and I'm continuously manifesting a home with a pool, unbothered, unharmed though. My health back, my son, and us to have a bigger and better place. Yes, indeed. Every day. Every day is a good day. I'm going to think positive again. And today, November 1st, I'm pushing through, you guys. I'm going to show you that I am worthy. I'm worthy of you guys' phone call. I'm worthy. I'm so worthy of you guys motivating me. I'm putting my right foot forward, and then I'm gonna put my left foot after that. And again, right foot forward. One step at a time, one day at a time. Yes, indeed. I'm gonna keep pushing through. And again, I am so grateful and I am so thankful for you guys reaching out to me. Yes, indeed.